So here's a new idea. Something like jazz, but funk. Like Neon Knight Riders or Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Thank you.
this riff in Prelude 17 of Well-Tempered Clavier. The idea. Well, just in case you don't get the idea, when you read Well-Tempered Clavier, if you haven't already figured this out, you can pull the riffs from it and not actually learn the tedious pieces, and that's the best way I found to learn from the Well-Tempered Clavier after learning the first three preludes. Let's take the end of Julia and use that as a base of a song. So Julia, just like that, the end of Julia is... So let's use that as a song. So... Something like that. Okay, it's working.
Thank you.
that piece, there's two different ways to approach it. When I first played it, I did everything. And then. So going high low and going low high, low bass notes. It's more interesting but more difficult if you're going to put this in a computer. To change the orientation, have both notes follow each other. So. Like that. Something like that.
Too tough to play live. Here's a game you can play to learn the inversions of chords. This one, I think, is a little tedious, but not too tedious. Alright, here we go. But you get the idea. So you play each chord with something simple, focus being to memorize where the chords are. Here's another idea. So just take the two uncommon chords and work off those. Like the first major chord is a good example. So the two other chords is, this is the main, two other chords are, and the two black notes stay the same. So there's a G sharp and there's a C sharp, but the F is either the low or high octave, and then you go back to the one you know. Everybody knows the main chords. But it's also very easy if you take the other two, they hinge off two of the same notes, each of these other ones, so that's a good way to memorize them. You get the idea. Here's today's lesson. So, if you play the root note of the inversions, as you go through the inversions, it makes a great, it just sounds different. So you can play the inversions and it doesn't sound like the same chord as long as you're changing the root note that you play on one hand. So for example, with the left hand playing the root note. Let's do that again, one more time. All with the other hand. I don't need to play it with the other hand on the tape, but... And of course, that last chord is different. That's the fourth chord. But this is one, 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 four. Very easy, and you can do that with the root note. That's how you do it. Very easy.